Where to store files? It's a simple question, but most people don't know the right method. So here it is. I'm going to talk about corporate or business files in the context of Office 365. If you're in a hurry, here is the summary. If you create a file and you manage it primarily, put it on OneDrive. If required, share it with other people, and that's it. If it's a project, usually we create a team inside Teams for managing projects. So create the file directly in Teams. If it's a departmental file, it's already in some SharePoint site. So create the file there. And then if there is a file which is already on OneDrive, you are managing it, but later it becomes a part of a project, then move it to Teams or SharePoint. That's all there is to it. So there are broadly two categories, files you create and files other create and share with you. So let's talk about files or folders you create. Create a file. If you're going to manage the file, just store it on OneDrive. Now, if you decided to store the file on Teams, you don't have to go to Teams. In Word, Excel, PowerPoint, in File Save, you can see all the teams which you have access to. So go to the team, go to the correct channel and store it. So bottom line, you never have to go to this PC from now onwards. Never store files only on local drive. Even if I tell you that, you're not going to listen to me because you feel by putting files on cloud, you're losing control, and that's wrong. Why? Because when you put a file on OneDrive, a copy of that is stored on local drive, and that copy you can edit without internet. So absolutely no disadvantage, exactly as before. But on the other hand, we have many advantages, 12 advantages to be precise. You get up to 5 TB of space. You are never going to have a 5 TB local hard disk. And even if you have that, what if it gets corrupted or your laptop is stolen? Details of these benefits I've already covered in separate videos. Have a look at them. Once you store a file on OneDrive, just go to your file explorer on PC or Mac and you will find it there. This tick mark means the file is there locally as well as on cloud. So if it's a large file or a folder and you don't need it on day-to-day basis, then right click on it and say free up space. File names, folder names still visible with a cloud icon. When you double click on it, if you have internet connection, it'll download. So best of both worlds. That's called files on demand. Now Teams and SharePoint files do not sync automatically. So how do you sync them? Go to the team. There may be multiple channels. Now you go to the main first channel. Usually it's called general. Go to files area. Click on the documents tab and then sync. That way all the channels or subfolders will be synced. If you don't see a channel called general, go to any channel, go to files area, click open in SharePoint. Now you'll see the path where documents will be before the channel name. Click on it and then sync. On your local drive, whenever you have OneDrive synced, the folder will be called OneDrive hyphen company name. When you have Teams or SharePoint files, it is first company name and then the folders. Now what is the benefit? Whether it is Teams, SharePoint on OneDrive, now you can edit files offline and then they will automatically sync, not just with the cloud, but your other devices as well. Now let's talk about how to share files with others. If the file is open, just go to the share button, click on this gear icon and then choose who are the people and what kind of permission you want to give them. Read only without download, read only with download and edit. In case of Word, there is review. That means track changes as well. If the file is not open, find it in File Explorer, right click, share. The same dialog comes. Even on mobile OneDrive app, same way of sharing. You can also do it from OneDrive on browser. Exactly the same method of sharing. But there is one more interesting place. You created a group chat to manage some work quickly. You have added many people there and now you want to share a file with them. Don't just upload the file. There is a OneDrive option. I'm sure all your files are going to be on OneDrive now. So just select the file, open this drop down and permission is given to people in this chat and give edit permission. So even though you are sharing files with multiple people, file is one. Everyone is editing the same file. No more copy-paste, no multiple copies floating around, no confusion. Less effort, more impact. Now let's talk about other people sharing files with you. Most probably, they're sending attachments to you, but you have understood the benefit of sending links instead of attachments. These are the benefits. Show this to all the people around you. So everyone is now sending links to each other. Now let's say someone shared a link with you. 1 month later, you want to find where it is. Yes, you can look for the mail, but instead, if you remember whether it was Word or Excel or PowerPoint, just go to that app and in the file dialog itself, you have shared with me. Faster way of finding. If you go to OneDrive on the web, there is a separate area called shared, shared with you. So there you can see all the files shared by all the people. And then you can filter by person or by file type. But wait, I don't remember the type of file, but I remember the person. No problem. In the same OneDrive, there is by person. Click on it. You will see all the recent files. There's another one. The files were in the context of a meeting. Go to by meeting. Look at the meeting. You will see the files. So whichever way you look at it, it's a very easy way to find files shared with you. Now, if files or folders are shared with you, we need to think about sync. If a file is shared with you, there is no sync button. But if you open it in desktop app, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, it is anyway synced. But if it is a folder which others have shared with you, then go inside the folder and now you will see sync button. Click on it and now you can edit those files also offline. Now, because all your files are on cloud, everything is auto-saved. That's a great thing because files will never get corrupted. But there is one problem. What is that? I want to open a file, make some changes and save it as a separate copy. That's bad because all the changes are auto-saved to original file. Now that has to be done differently. Open the file, save it as immediately as a copy and then edit. Avoid that confusion. Open file, save as first, change later. Now, when the context of the file changes, that means you had lots of local files and now you have decided to use OneDrive or Teams or SharePoint. Now, what do you do with those local files? Don't copy them, move them. Why move them? Because if you copy them, the original file will remain and confuse you. Because when you put a file on OneDrive, it's going to make another copy of the file, which is synced. But this local copy is still there, occupying double space. Very bad. Don't do it. I created a file. I was managing it. It is on OneDrive. But now a new project has started. And I know this file deserves to be edited by everyone in the project. Now don't copy it. Again, move it. Finally, the last worry people have is if I keep files on OneDrive, I have so many people reporting to me. Someone leaves. I will lose those files. No. There is a proper system available which your IT and compliance team is managing. When someone leaves, the OneDrive files are not deleted. That access can be given to manager and or to the new person who joins. Everything which is stored on OneDrive follows all security, compliance and privacy policies which your organization has already set. If you put them on local drive, none of them are followed. So your data is more secure if it is on cloud. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, click the bell icon, and ask me questions or give me ideas for more videos. So that's it for now. Thank you. See you soon.